Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. And so for today, we're going to be taking a look at the iPhone 7, an iconic device released by Apple several years back that is currently making its return to some news, especially in the prepaid market. And so for those people who are interested in the specifications because you've never owned one, let me just go ahead and just throw that out there for you guys. So this device is sporting a 4.7-inch display, resolution's at 750 by 1334. It's got the Apple A10 Fusion. 2 gigs of RAM. There are three different variations, the 32, 128, and 256 gig model. This one is the 128 that I have here that's unlocked, and I do have a 32 gig that is currently locked to T-Mobile. Battery size is a 1960 milliamp hour battery. There's a 12 megapixel sensor on the back for a camera, and a 7 megapixel sensor in the front for FaceTime and selfies. Now, again, like I said, this device is making its rounds once again, and that's because several prepaid companies and MVNOs are selling this device at a very, very low price. You can find several places that's selling this device anywhere from like $50 to even as low as $30 and about as high as $100. And of course, those require port-ins and other requirements to get it at that price. But again, you know, there's people that's looking at the iPhone 7, never owned an iPhone before, and opted to go this because when you're asking around, like, you know, if I'm going to try an iPhone and iOS, what should I do? Most people have recommended the iPhone 7 as a Apple starter device coming into it before dropping big bills on like the iPhone 11 or even the iPhone XR or some of those devices. And you know what? It's not that bad. It's not that bad of a device if you actually wanted to go for the iPhone 7. It still holds up fairly well. One of the things that people look at is that the device is IP67 water and dust resistant. Now, it doesn't mean it's waterproof where you can just throw in the water forever, but it can handle a splash or two. One of the things that you can really look at with Apple devices is that they age very, very well. And this device will receive iOS 14 when that comes out. But I think it's on its last stretch before becoming non-supported, as the iPhone 6 is no longer supported by Apple and the 6S is soon to drop off that support list. Right after that, then the iPhone 7 will kind of reach that point. But for me, having the iPhone XS and various other Apple devices, the iPhone 7 is actually pretty solid in my book. I mean, battery has held up very well, maybe not for gaming, but for everyday usage and even taking photos. Videos has been superb. I love the fact that when you go 1080p and 60 frames per second, it just looks really, really good. And of course, a lot of the Google apps that, you know, run on Android obviously run pretty good on an iPhone. Never understood why Hangouts ran so much better on the iPhone than on Android, but hey, you know what? It works. So in total, even though this is a very old device, I can tell people that my experience with it doesn't really feel like it's an old device. And as I use a Pixel 3 on the Android side of what I tend to use as my daily driver, the iPhone 7 seems to hold up against it. So anyways, guys, that's my thoughts and opinions about the iPhone 7. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section of the video if you choose to pick one up. If you enjoyed today's video, smash that like button to let me know. If you just subscribed, hit the bell icon to be notified when I upload. And as always, aloha.